Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
So now let's see how we can solve this integral. And by the way, you can take a guess to see if the students solve the integral stage or not. Here's the deal. We have the integral and we have cosine squared of this thing. By looking at it, you should feel like we shouldn't be integrating this directly by finding an antiderivative. Especially, you know, this right here is a definite integral. So what we should really be thinking is, can we use an integral property to help us out? And the answer is yes. Which one though? This one. Let me write it down right here for you guys. When we have an integral going from a to b of a function, this is equal to the integral still going from a to b. But for the input of the function, we can add the a and b together, and then minus x. And I actually have a proof for this video. I will put that in the description for you guys. Well, let's just apply this identity and see what we can get. So this becomes the integral going from 0 to pi over 2. And then we have cosine squared. And by the way, you might notice that we have the pi and then the 2. Yeah, that's kind of a weird number, right? But anyway, so let me just put down the factor the 2 on the bottom, so pi over 2 like this, and then the top will be tangent of x. But instead of x, we are going to put 0 plus pi over 2 minus x. So that's just pi over 2 minus x. And then over the bottom will be 1 plus tangent of pi over 2 minus x. Okay. I'm not going to put on a dx yet, because this thing is what though? Well, let me write it down right here for you guys. Note that when we have tangent of pi over 2 minus x, this is actually pretty nice, because we can write that as cotangent of x. Why? Tangent and cotangent. Co because of complementary. If the angles inside add up to 90 degrees, which is pi over 2, then tangent and cotangent will be equal. If you remember that, then you can also remember the identities for sine and cosine, secant and cosecant. But I'm not going to put down cotangent x here and here. I will write to write it as 1 over tangent x. So this is just 1 over x. Tangent x, and this is also 1 over tangent x, which will end up with like a complex fraction. Let's actually just multiply the top and bottom by regular tangent x so that we can fix the complex fraction situation. So this is the integral going from 0 to pi over 2, cosine squared, and then we have pi over 2. This times that is the same as this times that, it's just 1. So it's 1 on the top over tangent x plus 1. Okay. Is this really helpful though? Because now this and that look very different. Well, thankfully we have the pi over 2. So if we can somehow have pi over 2 minus something, then we can use the co function identity for cosine, and then we can get sine, yeah? Okay, so how can we do that? Well, here's the key, have a look. We have tangent x plus 1. On the top, we have 1 already. Why don't we add a tangent x here? Yes, we can totally do that as long as we subtract that tangent x from here. Now, this will be the same as what we had earlier. And then if you take a closer look to here, let me put it down here. This over that is just equal to 1. And then we can have minus tangent x over, let me put down the 1 first and then plus tangent x. So this is for that. And we have the pi over 2 in front. So ladies and gentlemen, this is equal to the integral going from 0 to pi over 2 cosine square of pi over 2 times this, and then pi over 2 times that. So minus pi over 2 times tangent x over 1 plus tangent x. Okay, what do we have? Have a look. Pi over 2 minus an angle, and that's cosine. We can write this as the integral going from 0 to pi over 2, and change that to sine square of just this angle. Yeah? So it's the same idea like this one earlier, sine and cosine. So we have sine square of pi over 2 times tangent x over 1 plus tangent x. Okay, is this really helpful? Yes. What we have shown so far is that the original integral with the cosine, it's the same as this one, but here we have the sine. Notice the input are the same. And then look at, they both have the square. Now, we know cosine square plus sine square, when we have the same angle inside, it's just equal to 1. Now, this is how we can continue. First, let me show you guys the magic trick. That's how you should erase the board. Anyways, this is how you should solve this integral. What we want to do first is, I'm going to multiply this by 2, and of course, in the front, I will have to multiply by 1 half. And the reason is because we are going to break this apart into itself plus itself. So this is equal to 1 half times the original integral plus itself. That's how we can end up with 2 of them, right? But I'm not going to put down the same thing again. Instead, we are going to put down what we found earlier, because this is equal to the sine version too, right? So that's what we have now. And have a look. They both go from 0 to pi over 2, so we can just add the insides together. And like we said earlier, cosine squared plus sine squared is equal to 1. This is the 1 that we love. So it's just 1 half times the integral going from 0 to pi over 2, integrating 1. And this is just pi over 2. So take 1 half times pi over 2. Final answer, pi over 4. And that's it.
Okay, this was incorrect, and this is correct. Yeah!